two. Bloop, bloop. Verses 5-6 have this great little poetic portion. It says, for there is one God, right there, that's a nod to the Shema, which is from Deuteronomy. Hear, O Israel, the Lord your God, the Lord God is one. That's kind of the central tenet of all of Judaism that we see specifically in the Hebrew scriptures here, the Shema. So Paul is right, Paul, the author of this letter is right away nodding back to that central tenet, which is pretty cool. There is also one mediator between God and humankind, Christ Jesus. All right, this section, it's a little too exclusive for my liking. I prefer to think that God works through all sorts of ways. When we narrow it down to my way only, we just perpetuate us's and them's, which leads to all sorts of violence. Okay, that's not where we're going. Christ Jesus himself human, interesting inclusion, referencing the humanity of Jesus. I'm a big fan of that. There's a great book by Walter Wink called The Human Being, which is one of my top theological books ever, who gave himself a ransom for all. All right, this is the part I want us to sit with for a little bit. A ransom for all. A couple of things going on here. First, the word ransom. It's used here, again, the way that first line, there is one God, that's a nod to the Shema. Ransom would be a nod for the audience coming from a Jewish context to the stories from Egypt, when the Israelites were slaves in Egypt and they were brought out of captivity. That's kind of the framing tenet of the story of the people of Israel in the Hebrew scriptures. Well, that and exile in Babylon. Basically, exile and return is the consistent narrative we see. And here, this author is referencing ransom. Jesus is doing this ransom act. He is liberating the oppressed. He is setting the slaves free. He is bringing the exiles home. Right there. So this word ransom, it's a metaphor drawing back on their cultural history. It's a way of saying, remember that thing God did then? God is still doing that now. And it's a really great metaphor when you understand that cultural context. So that makes me think, what are other metaphors we could use for the work of God in our world today? When we think of the context out of which we live and work and all the things we do, what are the metaphors that would represent how God continues to, I don't know, bring life out of the dirt? That's a metaphor right there, I guess, already. But what else? What are the other metaphors that you could think of that describe what God is continuing to do? All right, answer that in a bit. Let's move on to...